Oh shit. Oh boy. Oh my god.
My eyes.
Welcome. I'm just welcome, in the process. Welcome. I need to change the title and everything. Podcast. Cool. All right. Well,
yeah.
I'm Jess.
I'm Bree.
Together, we make press. Okay, so the name came from our mum trying to call us at the same time. And it came out as press. Gotta love that. Thanks, mum, for the name. That's great. Oh, boy. So
I heard a hyena out my window. Sorry.
You sure it wasn't you laughing?
Going back to me.
Oh gosh. So we have lots to talk about today. First thing being books. I'm so excited. Books. Sheep. Oh my gosh, you guys. For those of you who are listening not on YouTube, there will be some videos and stuff, so that'll be up on YouTube if you want to watch them. Otherwise, you can listen to us laughing ourselves silly at them. Oh my gosh, my headphones came out.
My Twitch name.
Your Twitch name? What?
It's abbreviated to ass.
Ass is in the chat. Love that for you. Oh my god. Oh, that's great. Oh, so speaking of books, I'm an avid book reader, and I wanted to share a few TikToks from BookTok with you guys, if that's okay.
Oh.
Starting off with, okay, so Matt and most of the chat probably knows that I like reading dark romance and fantasy, obviously, but this first TikTok, relatable, just watch.
Uh-oh.
It's gonna play. But I want her to be tired from staying up all day, taking my to her body until she's depleted of all her strength. Even then, I'll still her. I deprived myself last time, refused to touch her with my own hands. And you're like, where's the sound gone? What the hell? What's going on?
When she hadn't earned that from her yet.
Oh, no.
But watching that slide in and out of her pussy.
Oh, so relatable!
Oh, no!
So relatable! Ooh. Second one.
Has that ever happened to you?
Yes.
Oh,
yes. Sometimes when I forget that my headphones aren't connected, it starts playing an audiobook that I've been listening to. It's the worst when you're at the shops. Yep. The worst. Oh, yeah. Unhinged, but we love it.
Love that.
Okay, so this is a new release that's coming out, oh my god, in 2 days. Ooh, wait. It'll probably be 3 days for me because America's 1 day behind. But, right. Oh my god. Chantal Tessier has a new book coming out on Halloween, the 31st, and this is sort of like a little trailer for it. I'm so excited. So excited. Hell yeah. The bikes and the spoopy.
The bikes?
I love it.
That's cool.
Oh boy.
That's awesome.
Yes. There is also
When your dad asks what you're reading on the family vacation.
He's like, what? Wow. He's joking.
You got issues.
You got issues. Can relate. Can relate. Can relate. My gosh. Can relate. Oi. So, those are my book talks for this week. I had a few more, but I was like, we'll start off a little more on the mellow side. I don't want to scare people away.
I don't want to scare people away.
But I do have three favorites that I've read. Oh, I'd probably say like within the past 2 months, 2-3 months. That I would like to share with you. And my aim for this is to try and get you hyped to read these books because I love them so much and I want you to love them so much so we can talk about it and we can gasbag about all the stuff that we read about. First one, Fourth Wing. Oh my gosh.
I've heard so much about this book.
I have been raving about it. It is so good. Especially since, like, I was in a book hangover from another book that I was reading. It was actually a series. And I was just like, no book is hitting. Like, I'd start books and I'm like, I'm just not into it. Like, nothing's really catching my attention. Mm. I started reading Fourth Wing. Oh my gosh. So good. So, the premise of this, obviously it's about dragons, but also, so it follows this main character, Violet Sorengale. She's 20, I think, and she's in her first year in the Writer's Quadrant at Basgaeth. I don't know, there's a lot of Celtic words in here which I'm gonna absolutely butcher, but War College. So,
you know what?
Yeah.
Unless it's an audiobook, like,
right.
It's however I read it
in my head. That's it.
Yeah. Them's the rules.
Yep. Oh, so basically, when you start reading this, you can really tell that the book's reiterating that she's weak and she's small and accident prone. So she's been raised to be, you know, to aim for like the scribes quadrant.
The scribes.
The scribes. Widowmatter. The scribes quadrant. Which is basically, you know, what scribes do. a lot of her symptoms are similar to those of Ehlers-Danlos syndrome. Have you heard of that before?
Oh, I have.
Yeah. So like joint pain and hypermobility and stuff. The author actually has that. So she's really like writing from experience, which
that's cool.
As someone who deals with chronic pain and illness, I appreciate so much.
That's cool.
Yeah. So the main character is really relatable. So when the time comes for her to apply for the scribes quadrant,
that's all I'm going to call it. Yeah.
The scribes quadrant. Her mum makes her try out for the writer's quadrant. And it's like,
widest
quadrant.
Sorry.
Oh, that's fine.
I've destroyed the book.
That's all I'm going to hear. Like whenever I read it, I'm just going to be thinking that now.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. And it's like, you're baffled because you're like, she's clearly very frail. Why would you make her try out to be a writer? Like, that's just ridiculous. Mm. And the thing is, trying out for the writer's quadrant, it's not like if writer's quadrant. If you don't get in, you can go for something else. No.
Sorry.
That's all right. It's not like, you know, if you don't get in, you can go for something else. It's literally, if you don't get in, you die. And a lot of people do. So
damn.
The writer's quadrant is trying to recruit the strongest and best people to fight on the front lines of their kingdoms, like with an ongoing battle. I won't spoil anything, all any political stuff, but there's stuff going on.
So much stuff.
So much. The first test is to pass along a parapet, which is like a big narrow walkway, I guess. But like it's balancing beam thin, like so thin. Ooh. And there's a hell of a drop either side. So if you slip, you die. And that's just the first test. That's just to get over to the other side. And they have to go through like grueling training for months and months. And a lot of riders die from that as well. It's not just like sparring or whatever. You literally have to like kill your opponents. It's sort of like the Hunger Games a little, but not. It's hard to explain.
It was giving me those vibes a little bit.
Yeah, yeah.
Just the fact that like if you don't like succeed, you die.
Yes. But the thing is, it's not as like it is cutthroat, but there is also some good people. Sorry, I'm adjusting the music. There is some good people there as well, but a lot of people you can't trust. So it's like, can you make friends? Is it safe? Like, I don't know. Yeah. So basically they need to toughen up and survive all of the training, and only then can they get the chance, just the chance, to bond with a dragon. And if you try to bond with a dragon and fail, you'll end up a pile of ash on the ground. So good luck. Good luck.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah. The cool thing about the dragons is that once you bond with one, you can telepathically speak with them in your mind, and you're like, you're connected. Yeah. And they actually share their power with you. But that's all I'm saying on that.
That's so cool.
It's awesome. Delicious love interest, enemies to lovers, bit of a love triangle. I'd say it's more of an urban fantasy-ish, with some spicy scenes. I'd probably rate the spicy scenes like 2 or 3 out of 10. Like they're nothing too raunchy where it like takes away from the magic of the story. But 10 out of 10 would recommend.
Do you think?
Yeah.
Do you think this could wait?
Yeah.
Is this being turned into like
a movie or a series? Like I bloody hope so. So the author has been hinting at something big coming, but she can't say anything yet. But I definitely think it will be. For sure. I can't
it's definitely
wait.
Definitely like one of the ones you could see.
Oh, for yeah.
sure.
Oh,
being a movie or a series or whatever. Oh,
yes. And the dragons and the. It's just. Ugh! It's like it's something. It's along the same vein of the Hunger Games. Like, we haven't had a good series like that in so long. Like, so long. And I feel like there's a resurgence now of all that old school stuff that we used to love back in our teenage years is, like, becoming popular again. And I feel like this really, yes, this is for us.
Question.
Yeah.
Do you think
mm-hmm.
it should be turned into a series of movies or a TV series?
I feel like a TV series would do it more justice because there's so much that goes on, and I feel like the movies, if it was a movie, they'd be very hard pressed to fit all the details in. But then again, I don't know. I guess if it's done by the right director, I can see it going either way, but TV series because I want more to watch.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Fair.
Yeah, valid.
I understand.
Valid. I wanted to share a couple of my favorite quotes from this book as well.
Oh.
A dragon without its rider is a tragedy. A rider without their dragon is dead. So basically, if your dragon dies, you die.
Oh, damn.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
I really want to read this.
Oh, it's so fucking good, dude. Highly recommend.
You're like, I've done it.
Here's another quote. Going for blood today, are we, violence? He whispers. Metal hits the mat and he kicks it past my head out of my reach. He's not taking my daggers to use them against me. He's disarming me just to prove he can. My blood boils. My name is Violet, I seethe. I think my version fits you better. He releases my wrist and stands, offering me a hand. The banter. Ooh.
We love some banter.
Mm-hmm. And last but not least, This place cuts away the bullshit and the niceties, revealing who you are at your core. So true. So true.
Damn.
People that I didn't, that I thought were good or bad, and people that I thought were bad or good. And, oh my God. It's good.
That's cool.
Just read it.
Twists and turns.
Read it. It's so good. I cried and I screamed and I laughed and everything in this book. There's probably tears on my pages somewhere. Some pages in there just with tear spots. Oh my gosh.
Nice.
Cool. Second book recommendation of the week. Haunting Adeline. Okay, this is not for the faint of heart. Trigger warnings. Read the trigger warnings on this book. It is heavy. There's a lot of taboo stuff in here. So maybe for a more seasoned reader, just saying. But basically, the premise of this book is Adeline is a successful author and her great grandmother passed away and left her like this big gothic house thing where her grandmother, great grandmother used to live. So while Adeline is there, she finds out secrets about her Gigi. But that's not the only thing. She realizes she has a stalker who somehow gets into her house and leaves roses for her and then vanishes all without her even knowing while he's there. Like, what the hell?
Oh my gosh.
First, she was like, oh, this is nice. And then it's like, okay, this is sort of creepy. Like, how is he getting in my house? I lock all of my doors. What the hell? Oh my God, this book. So good. So he's not just any stalker, though. One night, Adeline brings home a wink-wink date who gets a bit handsy, but, you know, she goes along with it. Not really enjoying it, but still thinks, you know, better than nothing, I guess. And what happens after her last conquest leaves the house?
Oh, no.
She finds his hands chopped off in a box on her front doorstep.
What?
Oh my, oh my God, you need to read it. It is so good. But yes, definitely read the trigger warnings because there is a lot of, there's some gunplay, there's some, hold on, let me get my book. Hold on.
Where is it? You gonna read the trigger warnings? She's running. You're running.
I got it. All right, what does it say? Let me read the trigger warnings for you.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
You're welcome. Wait, important note. Where are we? Trigger warnings. No, that's prologue. Oh, is there... Oh, there's also a playlist at the front. Amazing. Okay, this is prologue. What? There's no trigger warnings in the front of this. Stop it. Really? Okay,
did you get a defective book?
Well, this was actually banned for a little bit off Amazon because it was so taboo. Ooh, what lies beyond the veil? Okay, that has to go on my TBR. Thank you for the book recommendation.
Write it down right now.
Writing it down. Oh my gosh. But this book, 5 out of 5 for spice, is... Oh, I love smart. Great. Amazing. That's my cup of tea. I just ripped my headphones out yet again. Yes, it makes it a 10 out of 10 read for me. I'm going to read you a couple of quotes. Okay, here's the first one. So we find out that the stalker's name is Zaid. That's not a spoiler. Just letting you know.
Okay,
so... You're going to murder him too? Of course I am. Slowly too. Start with snipping his Achilles heel so he can't run, and then... That's fucked up! You're going to jail! She cuts in, disgust curling her lip. Actually, I hope you go to prison and are sentenced to death. She turns with a snarl, but she doesn't make it a step before my hand snaps out, capturing her arm and whipping her back around directly into my chest. Addie inhales sharply, her eyes dilating as I seize the back of her neck with one hand and grab her delectable ass with the other, lifting her up against my body. Will you be my last meal, baby?
Oh my God!
Feral. That's what this is. Oh my gosh. Yep.
Lord have mercy.
Uh-huh. Another little quote from Zayd. Sneaking off with random men, little mouse. If I catch his hands anywhere near you, they'll end up in your mailbox by morning. Hey. Stop it. Stop it. Stop it. Last quote that I absolutely love and will probably make you feral.
Oh gosh.
Let me know which stars you prefer, the ones above you or the ones I make you see. Okay, I'm dead. I'm dead.
I'm done.
Last but not least, Zodiac Academy. Okay, Wait, listen. This book gets a lot of hate. This series,
listen.
Let me tell you something. Okay, look, this book has a lot of hate. Like, this series gets a lot of hate because the writing is a little bit more amateurish. But and also, it's a bully romance, so it's not everyone's cup of tea. But I freaking love it. It's so good. Sheesh. All right. So, I want to try and convince you to at least give it a try, because for those girlies or guys or poiple who love
poiple
who loved like Twilight back in the day, but now sort of find, you know, like you're like, wow, how did I watch that? But still, it sort of has like a place in your heart. It's like that. It gives me that sort of feeling, like reading Twilight for the first time and thinking it's the best thing ever. This is like, I don't know, this has been the best series that I've read this year and I absolutely love it. I think number 9's coming out soon. Oh my God, I'm so excited. But basically, the first book, it starts with Darcy and Tori. They're twins who, yeah, there's 9 books, I know, right? Lots to keep you busy. So they're twins who grew up in the mortal realm, so basically where we are, and they were foster kids, but now they've grown up and they're living sort of on the rough side of town, stealing to make ends meet and not being exactly law-abiding citizens. But you know, you got to do what you got to do to make ends meet. So one night, someone from Solaria finds them in the mortal realm and basically tells them that they're fae heirs to the throne in Solaria. And with a little bit of vampiric coercion, they're whisked away to the awakening ceremony in Solaria. So if you're one of the fae, elemental magic it's just in your blood. You're born with it. Air, fire, water, earth. It's sort of like the sorting hat ceremony in Harry Potter, except with this, you can have multiple elements. Although it is very rare to have 2, even more so rare to have 3, but to have all 4, it's like almost unheard of. Not only can the fae in this realm wield elements, but there's also changelings. So like, think vampires, dragons, werewolves, sirens, so much more. Cerberuses, you know, the dog with the 3 heads?
Yes.
Yep.
Oh, pardon, sorry.
Yep. That's all right.
Sorry.
That's like a 7.
Okay.
So Darcy and Tori come in and basically have to attend this magic college, the Zodiac Academy. Otherwise, they're not able to get their inheritance. Their real parents left them. And being so poor, they're like, you know, we don't really have a choice. It's either this or we keep, you know, scrounging around for money and food and crap. So in deciding to stay attending Zodiac Academy, they've upset the hierarchy of things because their real parents are dead. there's a celestial council that has stepped up to rule Solaria in the meantime, and the four families of the four sons, they go to Zodiac Academy, and they're assholes. Absolute assholes. And you better bet that because Darcy and Tori have now come back to Solaria, the boys are all threatened and come up with a plan to knock the sisters down a peg or two and make them want to leave on their own, like make the decision on their own. So this is a bully romance, lots of spice, although in saying that, I reckon the spice comes in more so in the later books, and I highly recommend, highly, highly recommend the audiobooks for these. Bridget and Jake Bordeaux, they're a married couple who narrate, and oh my God.
Oh, that's cool.
The different voices that they give to each character just absolutely make the book. I am like listening to this series sometimes on Audible, and I'll be like mopping the floor and I will burst out laughing because of something that one of the characters has said. It's so funny. Oh my gosh. Definitely has to go on your TBR. Definitely. I need to read Throne of Glass. I started, but I got like four books in and then I sort of just forgot. I know it's horrible. It's horrible. But I've read ACOTAR, so that makes me feel better.
I have no idea what that is.
ACOTAR. A Court of Thorns and Roses.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
I know what that is.
Yeah. There isn't much smut. Yeah. I reckon ACOTAR has just the right amount of smut. I reckon it's good. New book coming out next year. I'm so excited. But yeah, I wanted to give you a couple of quotes. This is my last book of the day, but I wanted to give you a couple of quotes that might entice you to read it. Okay, here's the first one. To hate you, I'd have to care about you, and I don't give one shit about you. Second one. The most important thing I'd learned in life, you can't trust people, and you especially can't trust trust boys with wicked smiles and equally wicked intentions. So true. Third one.
FBI, open up!
Open up! third one. He lifted his head with a demonic smile. Welcome to your awakening.
Ah! Oh my God.
Last one. Ignore the dimples, Tori. He's an award-winning Dickosaurus. It's so good. It's so campy, but I love that. I love it.
Campy's good sometimes.
I love it. It's great. It's great.
Sometimes you want campy.
Yeah. It's definitely an easy read for those who are like in between books. Yep. Okay. Brie.
Oh, Lord.
On to music. Current faves that you have on repeat.
I have the same songs on repeat for like months.
Dude, I do too sometimes. Like, I've got a couple of songs that have just stayed on my repeat list for like 6 months now. So don't feel bad. It's fine.
Okay.
It's fine. It's fine. So the first one, we're not going to play the thing all the way through. I'll keep pausing, so if you
I
dropped my pen. Oh my God, I thought you were gonna say something else. Okay.
We're not on book talk anymore.
Not on book talk anymore. Let's reel it in. So I'll pause it and give you a chance to chat about what we just heard, and then I'll play it again, and just so we don't upset copyright, but also free use, we are adding to the commentary of this music. So
I
hey Henry,
wait to hear your songs.
Oh dude, I'm so excited.
And they're gonna be so cool.
Oh my God, I hope you love them, but I love your songs. First one is Dreamcatcher.
I'm embarrassed.
Catrara. Hey Henry, it's good to see you. Here we go.
I'm embarrassed.
Don't be embarrassed. Oh, the guitar. I can see this being in like an anime.
Right. It's
just tell you.
Wow! You need like a dancing kind of emote.
Yeah. I need to pop one in there. Oh, yeah. I like how they've dropped it right back.
Mm. It's like a wave.
Yeah. Is there any particular one that's like a leader or?
Like the leader of the group or the lead singer?
Like lead singer? Or they sort of take turns, they cycle?
They do cycle, but there is like a main vocalist.
Oh, yeah.
When it gets into the chorus, the first chick that's singing is the main vocalist.
Oh, yes. Okay, let's listen. Wow. The pauses. I love the bass. I was like,
it gives very like slap bass feel.
Yeah. Woo! Thank you, Henry. So good. Did you want to go into the second verse, or do you have?
Yeah, no, it's okay. I have no more things to add.
Alrighty, love it. I love that it's like, it's a mix between K-pop and rock. It's like that happy medium between the two. So that was Bon Voyage by Dreamcatcher.
Bon Voyage.
We have another one. Scream, also by Dreamcatcher. Let's have a listen.
I have like all their songs on my repeat list.
Ooh. Yes, Scream. Like almost in a minor, what's it called? Like
key?
Yeah, yeah. Like it's got that really creepy sound to it. I love it. I can hear the main singer now that you said that.
Really?
Yeah. Got more of a deeper timbre, like it's more warm and like it's powerful.
She used to be in a rock group before.
I can tell she's got that rock voice.
Yeah.
Ooh, the build up before the chorus. Hell yeah. Dude, that's like dirty. Like it's like a filthy beat. I don't know how to explain it.
Yeah.
Oh. Oh my god. I like the little. I did not do that in key. Apologies. Wow. Is there a rapper of the group? Like someone who does more of the speaking?
Yes.
Ah.
Yeah, well, there's a main rapper and there's like another one that is like a sub rapper.
Oh, okay. That's cool.
Sometimes.
Yeah, she sort of reminds me of, you know, the K-pop rapper girl, Jessie?
Yes.
It's got that real, like, punchy, like, I don't know how to explain it. That's good. I like it.
It's got that punchy.
Great way to explain a song.
Love it. Love it.
Okay. So next we have Icky by Card. Am I saying that right?
Icky?
Yeah. Okay.
It's different
okay.
than the ones that we've heard.
It's good. It's good to have a bit of variation. Let's have a listen. Ooh. Ooh, I like it already.
I'ma get down.
Hell yeah! Oh shit.
There's two girls and two guys.
I love them. Oh, the bass! Okay. I feel like this would have a viral, like, dance that would go along with it.
It does.
Does it? I freaking knew it.
It does. It was all over TikTok, all over my TikTok.
Oh my god. Woo! Yeah. Oh, I love the mix. This romantic kind of pill with the hatch. I get good on a gasping, that's my proud. I don't know what they're saying, but it's catchy as hell. I am adding that to my list. I love that. And yeah, it does. It has that type of beat that's like, you know, a viral dance is gonna be made to that. That's crazy.
I'll have to send you some of the TikTok.
Yeah, please do. Maybe for next week. That'd be cool.
Yeah, yeah.
Next song. Oh, and also in saying this, definitely go support the artist's original thing. That's why I don't want to play the whole song, because I don't want to take away from their hard work. So, but definitely go and support them. The next one is Undercover by Ace. I've heard of Ace before.
Yeah.
It's an
old song.
Is it? That's probably why. I think
it's like 2 years old or something.
I do know this song.
Mm-hmm.
I love it. Hey, girl, I see you on the solo. Yeah. Hey, so how she banging like a bongo? Let it go, got me strong like Santana. When I see you feel the rush, can I get to know what's up? They sort of remind me of EXO. Hell yeah. I feel like this sort of sounds like the stuff that we would listen to over here. The guitar. Whoa. I love the ballad singing voice. It's great.
Oh. Had to do the mandatory military service.
Really? It's just like,
and they all went like together.
Really?
Mm.
Oh my god, that's like Big Bang. Big Bang?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. So did they make this song or album before?
Before, yeah.
Oh wow. Are they still serving now or?
No, they just came back.
Oh, so we can expect new music from them, hopefully.
Yeah.
Fingers crossed. Okay.
I'm excited.
Yeah. There we go. Undercover. Wow. It's catchy as hell.
Yeah.
Hell yeah. Oh, dude, that's sick. What were you going to say?
No, nothing.
Oh, my gosh. Well, I definitely want to keep an eye out on them, especially since they've just returned.
Yeah.
Oh, hell yeah.
Hell yeah.
I thought that was you talking.
No. Oh, my gosh. That's awesome. Well, thank you, Bree, for sharing your favorites of the week, the month, the year. Yeah. Yes, drinking. Yes. Hydrate. Have some water. All right. So, glad to hear you're hydrating. That's great. okay, so my first song that I've had on repeat, dude, I have been listening to this since it came out. And
really?
I have cried maybe the first time. 10 times when I listen to it.
Do you get like full body chills when you hear like a really good song?
Yes. Yes.
Same. I get like teary sometimes.
Same.
And you're like, this is such a good song.
Yeah. This is what this song did for me. So, okay. Blink 182 Anthem Part 3. It is about when songs go halftime, but it like
that's when the tears start to come.
I love it. I don't know what emotional. It is. It's great. It's emotional. My second song. So apparently this song was created by AI, obviously probably with the help of people, but
really?
Yeah. So this don't laugh. I mean, you can laugh. It's Plan Z. We say Z here in Australia, by Boy What. So,
one studio session later. The crusted crab's
going down when sung from Plankton's point of view. Making sound, have them at their feet. They got a lot of shit to say about the chum. Let's see who's laughing last when I turn them into holographic me. You better run. Better run.
Just one bucket of me. Like a Plankton song. Turn your friends and your family into chum.
The secret formula will be. Hell yeah! You'll all see. I love it.
It's so cool.
You're the beach and I'm the tide. Hello? That's great. The second verse just really does it for me because he gets into screaming. With a capital E at the end from my best friend Eugene. You better run, better run, better run. Just one bucket helmet in your tongue. What? Turn your friends and your family into chum. The secret formula. I love it. Oh my gosh, it's so good. You'll all see. But the fact when he goes, better run, better run, better run. Oh my gosh, yeah. I can't. It just...
Yeah.
It hypes me up. I cannot explain how much.
You're like, yes, let's run.
Oh my God, yeah. Where am I running to? I'm running somewhere.
I'm running.
But we're running.
Running. Oh,
now, this is a little different to the other ones that I've played, but still one of my most replayed of the week. It's sort of like my sad girl song for the week.
Okay.
But the thing is, the lyrics aren't sad. I don't know what makes it sad. I think it might be like the music, but it's Agora Hills by Doja Cat. Like or raps in like a, I don't know, like a valley girl, oh my God, accent sort of thing. Even like her, I don't know, the way that she pronounces her words in that one part is like that, and then she the other one is like her real tough, I don't know. I'll play it for you if I can find it. Where is it? That line, like Fortnite, I'ma need your skin. What the hell? I can't. She just is, she blows my mind. It's basically like her going back and forward between the two people, like her persona and something. It's just, it's amazing. I love it.
That's cool.
It's good.
Yeah.
Next one, totally like 180 from that.
Out of left field.
Look, my music tastes very eclectic, all right?
So I understand.
Mm-hmm. So one of my favorites for this week is Code Mistake by Corpse Husband and Bring Me the Horizon.
Oh my gosh.
Great, welcome! We're just sharing favorite music of the week. This is one of my faves. Dude, you need to check out the video clip for this. It's so good.
Really?
Dude, firstly, that first line, fade out when Centralia does. Do you know what Centralia is?
No.
Centralia is a town. It's the town that's based off Silent Hill, so it's burning underneath. It's still burning to this day, I think.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, yeah. Fade out when Centralia does. Oh, my God. Dude, I can't. Shows off a dust, veins too many needles touch. Or like veins too many needles touch. Dude, this song was written for me. My veins have seen so many needles.
Oh my God!
Oh my God! In,
you're like, just for me!
In a medical setting. If pain is beauty, I'm a pretty bitch. I can't. Dude, I can't. If pain is beauty, then I'm a friggin' superstar, friggin' runway model.
I'm 100 out of 10.
Oh God. Oh, also, before we get into the chorus, this is Corpse screaming. It's Corpse. Listen. Time slash the Hell yeah. And when he says, I will never be them, it's like a feeling of, I will never be normal. And oh my god, I so fucking relate to that.
Like, I feel that in my
heart. Dude.
Think of my lost
so good. And
starting to believe there's only one way I can. If pain is beauty, I'm a guillotine.
If pain is beauty, I'm a guillotine. You bring the match, I'll bring the kerosene. You bring the match, I'll bring the kerosene. This next line from a few lines from Corpse. Oh my god, I'm gonna break them down because I love them so much. Let the gabapentin set in, suffocate me in my sleep. Remember when I used to have to take tramadol during chemo?
Yes.
And I used to say, like, I feel like I'm going to die in my sleep because it, like, relaxes me too much.
Yeah, yeah.
That's, I can relate to that line. Oh, my God. Yep, definitely Corpse screaming on the first one. Yep, 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 yep. Oh, anyway, highly wow. recommend listening to that. Corpse actually has a new song out where he does some screaming. What's it called? Let me check.
That's cool. That's a cool song.
Oh. So good. And I've got one more. It's an honorable mention because it's Australian, but first.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah.
I have a feeling. Oh, it's probably not what I'm thinking.
What are you thinking?
But it might be. I'm thinking. What's the group? That Aussie group. I forget.
Oh, the girl, the one who sings Lavender Bones?
No.
Stand Atlantic? No.
I guess I will find out.
Yes. Corpse's new song is called Disdain, and he does some screaming on there. It's actually really good. It's a lot heavier than his usual stuff. Oh, it's so good.
Cool.
So, Aussie artist, Melrose Avenue.
I've seen him on TikTok.
Dude. This song's called Through Hell, and it's so fucking good. Like, I could...
I could
my neck. I've been through hell, if you can't tell, I'll never be good enough for me. And none of my friends know what goes in my head. I'm waiting for the only thing guaranteed. I like that he starts off low. Dude, this is like the music I used to listen to back in high school.
I was about to say it gives me like
Yeah. Saving it right now? Hell yeah. Just wait until the chorus comes in the second time. Hell yeah. I love his voice. I like the raspiness. Here we go. Oh, yeah. Wow. Dude, the fact that he can oh my god. But he like belts it. Like dude, I could eat that up with a freaking fork and a spatula. I don't know what the fuck I'm saying, but it's so good. So good. So, Aussie. I'm very proud to be Aussie because, man, that music is fucking awesome.
That's awesome.
Oh my gosh. Oh, you found a song the other day? Master of War by Peyton Parrish. I will check it out. Oh my god.
Oh.
Peyton Parrish. I'm writing it down so I can have a look when I'm off stream. Thank you so much. I'm always looking for new music, so please feel free.
Absolutely.
So exciting. Now, TV series. Aubrey. 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 Okay.
Aubrey.
So.
What?
You have watched a TV series called Happiness?
Oh, yeah.
Yes? All right. I thought maybe we could watch the trailer so we can see
what... I've never watched the trailer.
Really? You'll have to tell me if it's an accurate depiction of the series.
Okay.
Okay. Here we go. So this is Happiness.
Okay.
Vicky. What the heck? Zombies? Oh shit. 최소한의 책임감이라도 가져보시죠. Oh my.
That's a pretty good trailer. Yeah.
Okay. I see you. All right.
K-dramas are my bread and butter. Oh, I love them.
My God. So.
I'm addicted to them.
How many seasons are there of Happiness? Just one?
Just one, yeah.
And how many episodes? Is it like super long or?
12 episodes and they're like about an hour long each.
Ooh. Okay, this is good. So basically they have to survive, I don't know, something's turning them into undead something.
Yeah, but it's mostly all set in like their apartment building. They get like quarantined in their apartment area.
Oh my God, that's crazy.
And people are turning in there.
Oh God.
And it's so you don't know who's infected either because it's a really long incubation period.
Really? Oh no.
And you don't know who's infected.
That's so scary. That's oh my God. Ooh. Yeah, Brie watches K-drama. She is our K-drama aficionado.
Hell yeah.
You have a show on. It's called King's Avatar. Ooh. I will check it out.
Ooh.
Sick. We love recommendations.
Oh my gosh.
Mm-hmm. Now the second one.
Sorry.
That was a 10. That was a 10. Chinese shows are actually really good. They're really good. So this second one that you've watched is called Moving.
Yeah.
All right.
It's on Disney Plus.
Okay. Amazing. Mm-hmm. I'll play it right now and you can tell me if it's accurate.
Okay.
K-drama zone.
이상해? 다른 거 아니야?
What?
다르다고.
Upside down?
이상한 게 아니고. 뭐가 이상해?
Why is it so loud? Is he Spider-Man?
다른 거 아니야?
Fly.
What? He's like Superman. Dude! It sort of reminds me of My Hero Academia, like all the different powers.
Yeah.
So he's not the only one with different powers. I saw the guy with the electricity fist. Electricifist.
they got it from their parents.
What?
So their parents have abilities as well.
Okay.
And
Incredibles.
There's like the Incredibles. The Incredibles in Korea.
Yeah.
But there's this like organization peoples that are trying to take out everyone who has abilities, like kill, murder.
Dude, that sort of reminds me of the Umbrella Academy.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Mm.
All right.
How many episodes in that one? I think 20 episodes.
Oh shit. Okay. So
it's a long one.
Wow. I might watch that when I'm recovering. That's sick.
It really surprised me. Like I wasn't expecting much. I'm like, okay.
Yeah.
Sure. Let's try it. And at the end of every episode, I'm like, I need to watch the next one.
Wow. All right. That's sick. My gosh.
Mm.
It is on my list. Okay, next one. Taxi Driver?
Oh!
Okay, let's watch this and see what it's about. Shit. A taxi driver. Oh, shit, that's loud.
A taxi
driver. Oh, I like the music. What the hell? Whoa! Okay.
People come to them. They front as a taxi company, but people come to them to get like justice and revenge on like.
So they're sort of like hitmen.
Yeah, like the people that the police and the justice system don't help, go to the taxi company and they do it for them.
Oh my god, are you kidding?
Mm. And there's a cop after them, obviously. But yeah.
But they're doing the Lord's work.
Right?
Oh my god. Because how many times has, like, you know, the justice system not been so justice-like?
Exactly.
Wow.
Yeah. Dude. There's 32 episodes.
I am watching that. Yeah. That is on my radar. Holy crap. Yeah.
Season 1 is on Netflix.
Okay.
And season 1 and 2 are on Viki.
Viki. Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. Holy shit, dude. Yeah, thank you.
It's so good.
Thanks for the recommendations. Holy crap. Mm. Yeah, it does look good, Gray. Yeah.
Also, what was it? The Rotten Mango podcast. They did
thing
about it. All the cases are real life cases, by the way.
What? That's just blown my mind.
Yeah. They did a thing about there was this like corrupt CEO that was bullying his workers.
I heard about that.
Yes.
Oh my god.
And that's in the show too. I think that's in season 1. So yeah, and it's like every 2 to 3 episodes there's like a new case.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it's really good.
Oh my god. Well, really yes, good. I will only be watching season 1 as well to begin with.
And then I'll lend you my Viki login.
Thanks. Oh my god. Thank you for the recommendations. They were sick.
You're welcome.
Oh my god. Well,
I want to see your series.
Okay, dude, I don't watch much TV, so I'm really sorry if these are like old or not up to your standards. But okay, so this is just ones that I've watched the most recently. First one is Alice in Borderland.
Yes.
More mountains. Dude, imagine you come out of the toilet and no one's there. No one's around.
That would be insane.
Tokyo の人ってどこ行っちゃったんですか?
Oh my god. So good. Shit. So good.
I love it.
It is on Netflix. I actually think there's 3 seasons now. I've only watched the first one.
I've only watched the first one too.
Dude, it's sort of like The Hunger Games meets Saw almost. Like, yeah. It's hard to explain, but there's like game makers who have set up different games around the city, and you have to play. Like, you can choose which games to play, but you have to play in order to get, what is it, time? Or I can't remember what it is. Resources, something. But anyway, they you're forced to make sure that you have to apply to play one of the games. It's so good.
Yeah.
So good. Netflix, Japanese Hunger Games, 100%. It's so good. But it's like, it's so brutal. I love being able to see all the slicing and dicing and shit. It's so good.
I think I watched that before. I think that came out before Squid Game even came out.
It did. That's why I was sort of iffy about Squid Games to begin with. Same. But I enjoyed it. I thought it was good. Now, this one is my second series that I want to put you guys onto. It's the Junji Ito collection. So Junji Ito is a manga artist, writer, and he comes out with all these creepy ass stories. And this is basically like a collection of his short stories. It's so good.
Awesome.
It's creepy. Good for Halloween.
Perfect timing.
Okay, yes. Yeah, Japanese creepy pastas, yeah. Oh, hell yeah.
That's awesome.
じわりじわりとにじり寄る笑いにも似た恐怖と美しく儚く変容する万華鏡のような怪奇の世界へようこそ。
The Junji Ito Collection from 4th August.
Yep.
Hell yeah.
Dude, there's this one. Oh my god. It's insane. So there's this one where people's heads blow up into like these, how can I explain it? So they get hung from their own balloon head. Like,
oh my
gosh. I can't explain it. And they follow people around town. It's creepy. Oh, that's creepy. It's creepy. Zora watched them.
Unsettling.
Hell yeah. I thought that would be up her alley. And last but not least is also another anime.
Yeah.
Love that. Made in Abyss. This is not for the faint of heart. This is very graphic. So warning before you watch this trailer.
FYI. You have told me about this. I really want to look, watch it.
Okay. Hold on to your butt.
Okay.
In the Abyss, there is nothing as impartial as death. For all living creatures, death is sure to eventually come. Death is the equalizer. It is an absolute truth, and it's always lingering just within reach of us. People make the best use of their wits and courage. Struggling, floundering, they cling to life until the very end. And soon we realize this unjust and indifferent world, it's just the way we like it.
Ew. Sentai. Oh, I hear your doggo.
I want to become a white whistle so that I can be able to catch up with my mother.
So it seems she's alive. That little imp. Am I really just a relic? Why did I come here? What am I?
The deeper you go, the greater the physical toll becomes whenever you try to head back home.
At the Netherworld's bottom, I'll be waiting.
the abyss. You talk about it like it's no big deal. But if you go there, you can never come back.
Yep. Because you can't ascend.
Down at the deepest depths.
When you ascend, you get really sick.
It's no use.
It's about time you understand the full picture. Over the span of many years, with a spirit of adventure for the unknown, and with legends luring them in, many people.
I feel like this doesn't do it justice.
Swallowed up by the chasm's beckoning call. Swallowed up by the abyss.
So there's different layers to the abyss. There's like, but yeah, no, it's so good because if no one has reached the bottom of the abyss and come back up, because if you reach the bottom, there's no way you're coming back up because it's like, it's way too deep. Your body can't, Yep.
Like just for good? Like you just got to stay there?
Yep, you just got to stay down there. And I don't think anybody's actually reached the bottom of the abyss because like in certain levels, your form starts to change and you're not human anymore. And it's fucked up. But basically these kids are from an orphanage and they're red whistles. I think it's red. So they go into the first layer of the abyss and like forage and try and find like artifacts and stuff. And bring them back up. But this blonde girl here, her mum is a white whistle, which means she's been down a certain amount of layers. Whoa. And she's like, only the strongest of the strong can be a white whistle. But it's really good. Highly recommend,
that's cool.
But very graphic. Like that didn't show much, but it's very graphic.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Oh boy. So,
do you know how many episodes there are? Or?
Ooh, good question.
Where do you watch it?
Netflix. Netflix, you can watch the first season. Then I think season two and the movies in between are exclusive to HiDive, I think.
Oh.
But I loved season one. It's so good. But it gets more fucked up the more seasons you go in.
Have you seen all the seasons?
Yes. Yes. Ooh. And he's still writing the manga. So I think volume 11 just came out this month. So,
oh my gosh.
You have HiDive? Dude, nice. Okay. So you need to watch season one, then the movie in between, and then season two. And Crunchyroll? Hell yeah. Dude,
hell yeah.
You need to do the lawsuit thingy even though you'll probably only get like $30, apparently Crunchyroll, I don't know, sold people's data in like 2020.
I have Crunchyroll.
Did you? Okay. Did you have Crunchyroll in 2020?
You mean just as a subscription or
yes.
What?
Yes.
Maybe. I don't know.
Uh-huh. Okay. So double check because you can apply for the lawsuit thingy and Crunchyroll has to pay everyone who is subscribed. I think it amounts to like $30 each customer, but
nice.
Like it's a free $30.
That's like 2 months subscription.
Exactly. 2 months subscription for my information. Sign me up.
Sign me up again. Let's do it.
Oh my god. All right, movies. So Brie.
Oh, yes.
You have watched Insidious?
Can you hear my dog?
No. Is she bow-wowing?
Bow-wowing.
Crunchyroll account is new. Bummer!
Poo. I did have a Crunchyroll account, but I don't know whether I had premium or not.
Yeah. Double check. So, first movie that you watched this.
Oh, yes.
Insidious, The Red Door. Okay, let's have a look.
Five.
Oh, shit.
Four. Three, two, one.
Dalton! Are you ready?
We're ready to forget the further, once and for all.
I just see him as Ed Warren now.
Same.
My brain just been foggy past few years. All I ever wanted was to be a good dad. Dalton.
Oh, hell no.
Renee.
I don't know what it is, but this feels a bit B grade.
Yeah.
Ew.
Did you ever try and get help?
Nah, I'm just trying to push through.
That always works.
Why don't you drive Dalton to college? You still have a few weeks before your students show up, right? Just an idea to reconnect. I know it's been tough with you too.
We love Blumhouse.
The balance of light and dark.
Blumhouse, Blumhouse.
You're in the art school, I take it?
Yeah. You go here too?
Yes.
Draw an experience that defines you.
When I was 10.
No, I want to watch the FNAF movie so bad. Ah! Ew!
But I don't even remember being sick.
Sink deep into your memory and let's see what light can find.
It's really good. I know Maddie wants to watch it.
Yeah.
Ooh, the music!
Oh, I'm seeing crazy stuff.
Oh my, the window!
I think these drawings could be clues from my past.
There's so much you don't know.
When I was too scared to tell you the truth.
Our family has been keeping secrets. They suppressed our memories, but I can still feel something following us.
There's only one way to find out.
So they're gonna, oh boy, that's a bad idea.
Can you hear me? I feel like I'm getting closer to something.
Don't pull on it! Ew.
When you awaken the dead,
oh.
The further you travel, the riskier your journey will become.
Okay, so,
what
did you think of it when you watched it?
I didn't like it.
Yeah, I don't know. Judging from the trailer, it feels a lot more B-grade than the first one.
Yeah, I don't know. It wasn't scary. It didn't scare me, like, at all. And it was really boring.
Oh, that's a bummer.
To me, personally.
What a bummer. Man.
I don't know, because, like, the first Insidious scared the shite out of me. It scared me so bad.
Yeah, I don't actually think I've seen the first one, to be honest. I need to watch it. I know, I need to watch it. I know. I also need to watch the new FNAF movie. Oh, my God.
Same.
You went to see the animatronics in person.
Oh.
Oh, my God. I've seen TikToks about that. Remember that TikTok I showed you?
Yes.
They look so cool.
Yeah, they do.
Holy shit. But yes, I do need to watch the Insidious movie. Maybe that can be...
At least the first one. The first one was good.
I don't know. Maybe they've got a different director for this one.
Yeah, I don't know. It just...
It fell scary. A bit flat. Oh, yeah. That's a bummer.
It did definitely feel very B-grade too.
Oh, yes, pictures. Please, Gray. Please. Yes, please. Yeah, I don't know. With this... I forget what I was saying.
Not scary.
Not flat. I feel like things that have just a lot of jump scary stuff aren't scary. It's it's the subtle horror, like Haunting of Hill House. Just Hill House. I don't know.
Yeah, the Haunting of Hill House. Yeah.
That is scary because there's so much suspense being built and it's not constantly like in your face. It's just that feeling of unnerving, unsettling, like uncomfortableness.
Yes, the uncomfortable is great.
Whereas this feels a lot like cheap scares.
Yes.
That's a bummer.
And the scares weren't scary.
Yeah.
I didn't even jump once. You can see them coming.
Yeah. Oh,
that you know sucks. When the jump scares are happening.
Man, well, that's not going on my list.
No.
So you said you also watched The Equalizer 3. I haven't watched number 1 or 2. I don't know what they're about. So.
Good question. That's a great question.
Well, we're going to watch the trailer for number 3. Let's have a look.
9 seconds.
Oh, that's loud. Sorry about your ear holes, guys.
Penso che un sogno così non ritorni mai più.
Okay. cleaver. Okay.
That's what I'll give you to decide your fate.
I thought the chair thingies were swords, and I thought he was a monk.
What did you do back then?
Nope. Wrong.
Government work.
Wrong. Wrong.
I understand pain, death.
For you.
Como está?
Babani. Because of these people, I'm beginning to understand real peace.
Roberto, this is my wife. Ciao, ciao.
Oh, that peace isn't going to be very peaceful very much longer. Very much longer.
I see you as one of us now.
This is where I'm supposed to be.
Oh, wow.
Dakota Fanning's in this.
Really?
What happens here happens in many towns.
She's an adult.
Wow, that's so weird to think of her as an adult, hey?
They're like cats.
Yeah.
Thank you, Graham. It's sad because this sort of stuff is happening now still.
Who said you could come here?
You should stay out of other people's business.
Whatever it is you and your friends do, do it somewhere else.
Are you warning me?
I'm preparing. Is that a Timex?
No.
It's a boot.
Oh, shit!
That's the median nerve that I'm compressing. That's a level 3. If it goes to level 4, you will shit on yourself.
Make him shit on himself. Do it.
Do it.
Yeah.
You seem like a man who understands violence.
I like
it. Okay.
You can't take that from me.
I can take anything I want.
It feels like they're trying to do John Wick.
Police found multiple dead bodies on that farm.
Oh, there she is.
Did you kill him?
Monk.
<9 seconds.
laughs> He's a monk. Shit.
Do I look like a killer?
I mean, yeah. Damn. Shit. Okay.
I don't know. It's the action's cool, and he's very like he knows what he's doing before he does it. It's very I can't think of the word.
Yeah. Calculated.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I just.
Yeah.
The action was cool, but the rest I didn't really like.
Yeah. I can see that. Like, that's not really my cup of tea either. Although I love John Wick, so I don't know.
Yeah. It was.
Yeah.
It was okay.
Yeah. Okay.
I wouldn't rewatch it.
Yeah. Interesting. Well, thank you for the recommendations, bruh.
Mm-hmm.
Bruh.
Or the not recommendations.
Or the not, yeah, steer clear of.
Steer clear, yeah.
So, for my first movie recommendation, I only have two. Yeah, it's a Denzel movie, yeah. I mean, I feel like I like some of his movies, but I'm not a massive fan, I guess.
Yeah,
I don't know. So, my first recommendation for a movie.
I'm so sorry, before you start.
Yeah.
Speaking of John Wick, have you seen that there's a series on Prime?
No.
Called The Continental?
Yes, I have actually. I've added that to my list. Thank you.
Same. Yes. It's okay. Like a prequel.
I like it.
Hmm.
Cool.
Well, anyway, continue. Sorry.
I'm going to check that out. I've got on my list to watch.
Nice.
Now, this one is a bit of an old one. It's from 1999. Deja Vu. Oh, yeah. True. That is a good one. Are we ready? This one is called Stir of Echoes.
Okay.
Now, I saw a guy who got a 2-inch needle stuck into his arm while he was under hypnosis. Didn't feel
it. Thank you.
Okay, Kreskin, prove it. Hypnotize somebody.
Yeah, do me.
No.
Come on. What's the worst that can happen?
Well.
Close your eyes. Close your eyes.
I know that song.
Are you okay?
What the hell did she do to me?
The music makes it so horrible. I'm so sorry.
He hasn't gone to work. He sleeps like 12 hours a night.
Why are you digging?
The man's switch got flipped.
He's a receiver now.
She's taking him away.
She was here.
What's the problem?
The music. Wow.
That's an old trailer for you.
Wow.
Don't be afraid of it, Daddy.
Oh, it's based on a novel. No wonder I like it.
He like, can't that's
slow it.
It
down. We can't even figure it out.
No! Whatever door you open in my mind, I want you to shut up.
Yeah, good old Kevin Bacon.
What's the first movie you think of when you see Kevin Bacon?
Halloween.
He was in Halloween?
Yep. Yep.
Right.
He was a guy who got an axe in his head.
Oh.
But also, Footloose.
Yeah. Same.
Same. But that's like head and head. Head to head. Head and head. No.
We're head. Not on Book Talk.
No. We've closed that door. No Book Talk. Footloose is really good. Oh, my God. Dude, we sort of grew up like Footloose. Certain music we couldn't listen to. Know what I mean?
Know what I mean?
I had to hide my Sum 41 CD in a Mariah Carey case.
Mariah Carey.
I did. I still remember it to this day. It was in a Mariah Carey Christmas case.
Yeah.
She's in the snow Christmas in a red Santa friggin' suit.
Yes!
Yep.
I know the album you're talking about. Mm-hmm,
that's where I hit my Sum 41 CD. Oh. Oh, boy. So, highly recommend. It's, obviously you saw he gets hypnotized by his sister-in-law. And
it's trippy.
I don't know. It opens something in his brain where he's seeing and hearing things that he couldn't before. It's creepy and it's good.
That is creepy.
It's done well. It's done really well. So well.
Okay.
Okay.
Probably because it's based off a novel.
Probably, yes. You know what? I need to watch that novel.
Read the book.
Yes. Watch the novel.
To watch that novel.
I need to put it on my watch list. I don't know what the frick I'm saying. And the second movie I've got is called Run.
I've got that on my list.
Watch it, dude. Watch the trailer. It's so good. So good.
Okay.
Will she be okay?
Bit loud. Sorry.
Sorry.
Sorry. So she has a daughter
you'd
that's
do everything for me.
Disabled.
You'd teach me. You'd cook for me. Am I a burden?
Sweetheart.
I could do more.
I'm your mom. It's my job to take care of you when you need me. And you need me.
Are you okay, Mom?
Of course I'm okay. I have you.
Psychotic.
Wait.
I think you're gonna put two and two together.
Oof.
Yes.
The medication has messed with her head.
What's wrong?
Get me out of here!
You need me.
And the actress that actually plays the daughter is disabled in real life. Like, she's actually in a wheelchair, which I'm so glad they cast her.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Sarah Paulson's good at being crazy.
Oh, yeah.
He figured it out.
We know that from American Horror Story.
You need me.
so good, dude. So good. You need to watch it. Have you ever heard of the true story of Gypsy Rose and how her mum, her mum was feeding her all these cancer drugs and stuff, and she convinced the doctors that she was sick, and she kept her sick with like medications and stuff.
Yeah.
Yes. Based off that. So good. So good.
That's awesome.
Highly recommend.
That's cool. That looks creepy.
Dude, it is. Oh boy. Now, we're getting towards the end slowly. But we wanted to share our favorite TikToks of the week. There's so many TikToks. It's hard to choose.
I know.
But we're going to do yours first.
Oh, hell okay. Hell yeah.
Ready?
I'm ready.
And for those listening and not watching, you can watch the TikToks on YouTube. And we've also included the creators' original tags in the video as well. So make sure you support them. Also. I love when she dances. I think it's great. I honestly love it.
Same.
I think she should dance more.
I'm Renata Bliss.
I'm Renata Bliss, and I'm your dance.
Freestyle dance.
Oh my god. If there's no tomorrow, I'll be the one to follow. Yep.
Yep.
I love how he turns. He's just like, yeah, you watching. Oh, baby. You're going to go up to Karlak in this playthrough? Hell yeah, dude. Oh, well, that puss has been somewhere it's not meant to have been. Sometimes I find webs in Monty's whiskers, and it's like, dude, where have you been?
That's what it reminded me of.
Let's pray. Heavenly farts.
Oh, that's great.
That's funny.
All right. We'll do this one next.
Cheddar cheese into our air fryer. And we're also going to need some truffle cheese. Then add the fart that would emit from this amount of dairy would cause World War III.
Yes. Yes, it would. Oh,
why
my god.
So much cheese?
That's way too much cheese. Why would you air fry cheese like that? That's mental. Slices, dude.
That's enough slices.
I'm done.
Slices. I didn't send you this one.
No, but you did send it to me a while ago. I love it. Pass it along. I love it. And last one. Tom Cardi. Oh, yeah.
On the horizon of this forest path, you see a group of dark cloaked figures proud slowly Aussie trudging towards you. What do you do?
My half-orc barbarian braces her great hammer, and that's a one. Critical fail. Steve, what do you do?
Well, I believe in anticipation, my rogue would try and hide behind a tree. Okay, I rolled a one.
That's another critical fail. Tom, what does your human bard do?
Active perception check. That's a natural 20.
Let's fucking go.
I feel it in my fingers. I feel it in my toes. These motherfuckers need to harm us. And they got to go, so come on, get them now. You picked the wrong day to fuck around with my time. How good is it? Here's what we're gonna do.
Me and my boys gonna mess you up. I rolled a one.
Fuck.
My boys are otherwise engaged, so I'm gonna bring it on myself.
Hell yeah.
I forgot, you're supposed to tell me what I see, right? Yes, thank you. Let's just slow it all down a bit. So you notice that one of the hooded figures is a little shorter.
I cast Vicious Mockery, nat 20, let's go.
Let's go.
Everybody says,
shot!
Shot that guy. Yeah. And let's stop here from forming meaningful relationships. And when you were born, everybody thought that you were just a head. And when that guy said, wait, this is
a motherfucking tiny short ass baby. Got a tiny little itty bitty body and I hate it.
Your attack lands and I think it shatters the mind of the cloaked figure. Perception check, please. Nat 20, let's go. You perceive the figure was so short because it was a child. There's always a kid. Specifically the child you've been looking for the last 15 days game time and 5 days of our actual lives. Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't know I'll be better. His body's just lying there, right?
Yeah. Let's do it. Do it.
Yes. Don't.
Loot that body. Loot that body. Loot that body. Loot that body. When I loot that dead kid's body. Bitch.
Bitch. Dude, that was awesome. I loved your TikToks. Thank you for your...
Thank you.
For your... service. Okay.
I love it.
Starting with my first one, this song and these edits have been all over my For You page and I can't get it out of my head, and now I'm going to subject you to it so you can't get it out of your head. I love the song. Dude, the way they edit it and the fact that they put like the shadow where it's casting, like where the light's casting shadow, is just so cool. I freaking love it. And I've had a gazillion edits like that. And it's really catchy. So go and listen to the music. Here's another one.
So I just got one of the coolest D&D player sheets I've ever received, and the thing is made entirely of wood. This is made by LaserOx RPG Accessories, and this thing is a goddamn work of art! This is for the Bard class, obviously. Wheels to track your armor class, HP, spell save DCs.
So
they also
cool.
have these ball bearings that you can put for spell slots.
That's
we got
sick.
A Bard, so Song of Rest. Bardic Inspiration. The saving throws, reactions. They even have this side tracker to keep track of your stats with dry erase markers.
Yeah.
And yes, it does stand up. They have other classes on their website right now. So LaserOx, thank you so much and check them out.
That's so cool.
I need one. It's really cool.
I need it.
Okay, so this is Proud Aussie's Drunk. And you know when you're drunk and you just need something greasy?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Why has it got so many bones, bro?
It's a fucking chicken cunt.
It's a fucking chicken cunt.
What, you want a chicken with not have bones? How's it gonna get around?
How's it gonna get around?
It's legs, lad.
You don't have legs, you don't have bones, cunt.
You don't have legs, you don't have bones, cut. That's great. Oh, another one to make you laugh. Oh, that's great. That's great.
Oh, that's funny. This is a zoom past the camera.
I freaking love it.
If you
one.
Ride a motorcycle, you're stupid.
Correct!
Yeah! Yeah. I'm stupid. Oh my god, this just goes from bad to worse.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, poor dude. Now... Before you say anything about this next one.
Okay, I'm not gonna judge.
It's about the music, okay?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Focus on the music.
I'm sure.
And the guitar. Shut up!
I don't even know what it is, but okay.
Music. Mm-hmm. It is! I love it. It makes me want to cry. Dude, the hammer-ons are pull-offs. Stop it. And the fact that he has, like, resin inlay in his guitar, but also it annoys me that he's standing it on his,
On the jack.
On the jack. It is about the music, I swear. It is. All right. Okay.
Next. Stop looking at me!
Stop it! Stop! Okay. Dude. Disrespect you is around! And the fact that you can see the double pedal. Wait for it. Ding!
You won't make it out alive.
Dude, this makes me want to smash the drums. Hell yeah.
I love it.
My resolution is to learn that. Oh my god,
that double song.
Yes, but specifically that part. Yes, and also I do appreciate tattoos 100%. Yes, you're right.
You're right.
So I'm gonna.
You know me too well.
You know me well. You know me probably better than I know myself. But yeah, I'm gonna attach the double pedal and nice. Practice. Yeah, because I've got the drum set out and I've been banging around on it, but I've only been doing songs that are single pedal. So I really want to. Oh my god! All right, next.
I need to get a double pedal.
You should, dude. Oh my god, this is so much fun. This is what happens when I'm riding on my own. You can literally scream it. No one hears you. Oh yeah, yep. The amount of songs that I sing at the top of my lungs when I'm riding. Oh, 100%. You can turn any song into a double pedal song. I could turn that song into a double pedal song. Tonight! Tonight! I've got two more left. Here we go.
Okay.
Relatable. Oh, you belt songs out in your car all the time? Oh, I'm glad I'm not the only one. And last but not least, I love this because this captures our Aussiness.
Okay. What's the name? What? Sarah Marshall? Was it Sarah Marshall?
Sarah Marshall?
That's good.
I wonder you're still kicking back in the graveyard scaring people. Sarah's grave.
Sarah's grave.
Bro, I hope she grabs you on the nuts.
Sarah! Shut
up. What?
Bro, what was that?
What?
You can't just yell.
You can't just yell.
What? Yell?
This is so good. Oh my god.
Love it.
They are my TikToks for this week.
The TikToks. You don't really do that.
Yeah. You can't just yell. Oh my gosh. Oh. Now, on to the news. We're going. I don't know what else.
Double pedals.
I didn't get scared by that one that time. So, I wanted to share some news with you guys. Yes. You can get a free game today and tomorrow.
Again?
Yes. Listen.
It's Halloween, so we're doing the scariest thing that any indie game dev can do. Making our game Cult of the Lamb free. Well, it's free for this week on Switch with Nintendo Switch Online from the 25th to the 31st of October.
Yep.
So if you've not played our game Cult of the Lamb and you have a Switch, now's your chance to check out the trial.
Get it. Aussie game.
You know what else is free this week?
What's free this week?
The Evil Within 2 is free this week on the Epic Games Store.
Sweet! We love free games. Hey. Love free games. Oh, you don't have a Switch? No! That's poopy. Okay, moving on to our second news item. Bree, yes. Do you use dry shampoo?
I do, nearly every day.
Do you use Batiste dry shampoo?
I do.
Nearly every day.
Well, nearly every day.
You will want to listen to this.
So this was published on the 15th of August. We are now in October, but I did not hear about this until literally this morning. I use dry shampoo, specifically this one here. So this is just an FYI for anyone who uses the Batiste dry shampoo. This is also my...
So basically, shampoo. If you couldn't read it, it says... the dry shampoo was contaminated with benzene, a known human carcinogen linked to leukemia and other blood-related cancers.
Oh, well, boy.
While the manufacturer has denied allegations of contamination and denies that it did anything wrong, it has agreed to pay out the $2.5 million settlement to avoid the costs and distractions associated with continuing this case.
Oh, boy.
So, choose a different dry shampoo from now on.
Yeah.
Please. Okay.
Get your money.
Give me my fucking money. a little bit of news from Melbourne also this week. Oh, yeah. Our roads are shit.
Surprise.
So, all of these cars hit potholes, and they're all changing their tires because the potholes absolutely munted their tires.
I haven't heard that in a long time.
Their tires are absolutely munted.
Munted.
Yep. So,
wow.
Melbourne roads are shit. Munt. They're screwed. They're ruined. They're annihilated. Urban Dictionary me, please.
Urban Dictionary.
Oh my god. But yeah, these guys are measuring out the pothole. It's freaking huge. Wow. Yeah, they're fucked, basically, yeah.
Yep. Broken, ruined, significantly damaged, disfigured, or deformed.
Yep.
Munted.
Aussie word of the day. All right, moving on to our fourth news item. Fourth news item. Oh, please do. Go forth and hell use yeah munted in everyday life, and I want to hear what people say when they hear you say it. I want to hear it. I want to hear their reactions. I'm excited to
hell
hear.
Hell yeah.
Okay, fourth news item of the week.
So I come across this video the other day and I thought, look at this legend.
After a threat from a man holding a knife, mining worker Blake Tony took oof matters into his own hands. Another diner distracted the man while Blake tackled him.
He freaking tackled him! Like, he...
That's awesome.
Dude, he
my
rearranged...
My father and I were up in Dawai. Next thing you know, this fella like just comes out of the blue him and just starts yelling, I'm going to stab someone. And I looked at my father and we both hopped up. And my father picked up a baby high chair and started walking towards him. Got him distracted. I've walked around behind the fella and then come from the side and tackled him to the ground and done a citizen's arrest on him. So,
mate, not only did your citizens arrest him, but you fucking recalibrated his spine and initiated a system reset on the bastard.
Recalibrated his spine, all right? Jesus Christ. Oh, my goodness. Okay, news item 5 for the week. Nice. There's a thing over here that we call hoons, and they basically drive like crazy people. But this hoon is particularly skilled. Watch. Dude, he's like in Tokyo Drift. He's fishtailing, like he's doing fishies on the road. But he's actually got really good control of the car. Look, and he goes around the corner. Perfect. Doesn't scrub out once.
Wow.
Not once. Crazy.
That's so cool.
Super talented. Yep.
That's talent.
It really is. So news item number 6. So you know how prices of food and stuff are going up, and two big major food thingies. God, I love your accent. Sound.
Yeah.
Great. Love it. So
sorry.
Coles and Woolworths, or Woolies, they just posted their, oh, these are our profits for this year, like 56 billion, million, trillion dollars.
Yeah.
So, and we can barely afford to buy food. So people have started stealing stuff. So they've put cameras. Yeah. They've put cameras. Look it. So we have cameras watching us now as we shop. This is above the friggin' bread aisle. Bread is like, it shouldn't be expensive.
Bread is like close to $5 a loaf.
Right?
Now.
This is shit that people need.
Wow.
So prices here in Australia are going really shit. Love that for us.
Love that for us.
Love that for us. Yes.
Have you seen on a lot of TikToks where people are like, shoplifting,
yeah,
like from Safeway and stuff, or Woolies,
yeah.
A lot of the comments are like, if I see someone shoplifting, I'm just turning my head, like, because things are so expensive. Everyone understands.
Yeah, look, I understand. Holy shit, it should.
A loaf of Tip Top bread is like $4.75.
What the hell, dude? Did you hear that chocolate is now gonna be given a 40% rise? Like, cost, pay, like, us pay 40% more for fucking chocolate?
That's ridiculous.
Yep. Because the price of sugar, they're raising the price of sugar. Oh, so, gosh. Looks like I can be sugar-free in 2024. I'm a healthy bitch. But in reality, I just can't.
Not by choice.
not by choice. Can't afford sugar. Yeah, exactly. Don't get caught. I'm not condoning five-finger discounts, but you got to survive.
But I mean, I'm not going to see the five.
I'm not going to see the five finger discounts.
I'm legally blind.
I'm legally blind. News item number 7. This is actually for you guys in America.
America.
Welcome to the fucking news. I'm your host, Kellerman, and here's the weird shit going on in the world today. A dense super fog rolled into New Orleans last night, which is pretty and creepy on its own, but what's worse is that it caused a 150 car pileup on a highway that killed 7 people.
What
follow
the hell?
Me if you give a sh-
That's like the mist. Hello?
I was about to say someone freaking is cursed.
Yeah, someone opened Pandora's box or something. Put Jumanji back! Holy crap. Yeah, free 99. I wish. And last news item of the week, it's about a new game that's actually recently come out and I really want to play it. Oh. It looks really good. No, there was also a mass shooting in Maine
a
few days
ago. The guy's still, unless it's changed, he's still on the run.
What the hell, dude? Oh my god, I hope they catch him. That's mental.
There's a new horror game coming out where if you scream, the game restarts. Here, check it out.
If you scream, the game restarts.
Oh my gosh.
It looks like Blair Witch
Blair
Project
Witch.
Or something. Yeah. Ooh, look it!
Ew.
Gonna go ahead. Oh, it's so piss off. I would freak out. Go ahead.
That's so unsettling.
Right? It's quite a long video, so I'm skipping a bit. They last 11 minutes and 13 seconds. So it restarts. Dude. Wow. Oh my gosh.
I want you to play that.
Oh yeah, I'm going to be restarting like a gazillion times. Holy crap. Now on to our Aussie section. Aussie stuff. I'm excited to share some Aussie stuff with you guys.
Hold on. I will be back in 1 second.
No worries.
Okay.
All right.
No wakas.
No wakas. That means no worries in Australia. It's slang. Okay. First one is an old ad that we had back in the day. For Tim Tams. So Tim Tams, I think you can get them in Canada, but I'm pretty sure they originated in Australia. Don't quote me on that, but I'm pretty sure they did. And this is the Tim Tam ad that I remember as a kid.
Hey, look at this.
What is it?
An old lamp, I think.
3,000 years
ago. It's Cate Blanchett.
How dull. You know the deal? Three wishes and all that?
Three, huh? All right. I want a packet of Tim Tams that never runs out.
Man, I wish.
You have two wishes left. Then we'll have two more of those.
Are you kidding, dude? He's so dumb. He's so dumb. So you have three packets of Tim Tams that never run out. Just watching the Tim Tam ad.
Oh.
Remember that genie one? You know?
Yes.
Yep. Yep. An iconic Australian staple in kids' TV back in the day.
Feather rat. Cold Raddus.
Oh, Cold Raddus.
Leader of the bunch.
Leader of the bunch.
Cat called Modigliana. She's fluffy, but she's tough. Darren, he's a dopey dog. Lixie's a mother that makes the bunny.
Feral.
That's a feral's for ya.
Feral's.
Don't mess with the feral's. The feral's.
It's sort of like the Muppets, except very feral. Australian. Very feral, yeah. It's great. Some Aussie metalcore, some Aussie rock. I think you guys will be able to appreciate this.
Australian metalcore goes so hard.
It does. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. No.
Oh, my drive, that's who I was thinking.
Yeah. So good.
Hell yeah.
Highly recommend those bands. Yeah, Parkway Drive. They're Aussie. Love them. So good. Now, Brie, we grew up in a very ethnic family. Ethnic being, so our grandparents are from Europe, around like Macedonia, which is like sort of close to Greece-ish. It's like, it's that similar vibe.
Northern
Greece, European. Yeah. Yes.
You hungry?
This is like our baba.
You hungry?
You hungry?
Yeah. You hungry?
He's not hungry, man.
All right.
So
we can just
take it. I don't know what's happening right now. Please, for the love of God,
eat.
Please, man.
I said eat.
The amount of wooden spoons I got broken on my ass.
You come here, you eat.
I will.
I'll eat all of it.
Yeah, good the boy. You shut up.
Let's go watch a movie.
Eat.
What the hell is going on here? Sorry about my mum.
Yeah, it's alright, it's fine.
Yes, whenever we went to Bubba's house, it's always like, why you don't eat? You eat.
You make your Bubba sad.
You make your Bubba sad if you don't eat. Oh shit.
And when you're like, okay, she's like, okay.
Okay. She's like,
goes and makes something from scratch.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. Okay. Aussie koalas. Well, I mean, there is only koalas in Australia. Am I wrong or am I right? I mean, I suppose in other zoos, but still. Our koalas have Riz. Look at the way he's sitting! Dude.
What a majestic creature.
He's so majestic. Oh, boy.
10 out of 10 Riz.
10 out of 10 Riz, yep. There's also been some other wildlife that are very well known in Australia, especially spring, which we're in now.
The maggies.
Magpies. Yep. He's just coming in for a drink.
He just wants a schooner.
Yeah. He's singing for his food. Just chilling. Yeah, he's beautiful.
I reckon he's just asked for two schooners.
Yeah. Two schooners.
Yeah. I haven't seen this video either.
Really? Yep.
Yeah.
He wants two schooners. This is an Australian series, which is very highly controversial around the world, but it's sort of accepted here as, like,
dude,
normal. Yeah.
It's trending on Binge at the moment. Like, people have been searching it that much.
Piss off, really?
Yeah.
Chris Lilly is hilarious. So there's this comedian guy, Chris Lilly, who plays multiple characters in his own little series. I'll show you.
Okay, so this is a new cancelled show.
Oh, it's not cancelled here.
Anjanae.
This is Chantel.
Hi, Chantel. Oh my god, so you're going to Hilford?
Yep.
That's really cool. Mm-hmm. You'll fit in. There's so many Asians there.
I now see why.
Mum always says that even as a baby, our babies were crying and in a sort of monotonal way. But if I'd call out to Mum rather than Mum, like other kids, I would go, Mum, Mum. It's always
Mom.
Dancing and choreographing stuff. And I remember
a problem with aggression.
Jonah.
2 minutes,
pussy.
2 minutes.
Motherfucker.
Oh. Fuck you, motherfucker. Fuck you, miss. Fuck you, miss.
These are some bad kids. But they make great TV.
I don't make shit up.
He even made shit up that he made it 50 Cent.
Where are their parents? Where is his parent? Because I know his mom don't have him like this.
Made up.
I am playing it straight.
Oh. He was expelled from the other two, once for setting fire to a student's locker.
Yeah.
The other.
And, like, because it's going to be on the news and on TV and stuff, like, I don't want to brag, but I think they wanted someone decent looking. Because I'm, like, the smartest non-Asian in year 11.
I'm, like, the smartest non-Asian in year 11.
Such a good ambassador for the school.
Dude. Summer Heights High. Oh my god, if you want to watch it, it's called Summer Heights High. It's really funny, but also very controversial, so watch at your own risk. Melbourne, where we live, it's sunny at the moment, but today. Melbourne, yes, today, but yeah, podcast, hey! But Melbourne is known to have four seasons in a day.
Open up!
Woo! Yeah, so Melbourne is known to have four seasons in a day. And this is an accurate depiction of us here in Melbourne.
Okay.
What the fuck is that?
You son of a bitch.
You son of a bitch.
What do you mean is this? I'm wearing a hat. I don't know how to use it.
It's so
ridiculous. I'm going to drink so many beers. Get in the sun. It's so beautiful. Turn on the news.
Glowing orb above the earth. That's right. It's the sun. Melbourne has its sun again.
Yeah.
It's a great sunny day of 1938.
We love the sun.
The sun is out in Melbourne.
Hell yeah.
Oh, no.
Fuck.
Alright, well, we had a good run, guys.
What's the rest of the week look like?
It says it's 15 degrees for the next 4 years.
Which is cold. It's cold. Yep, and actually, I think it's going to rain tomorrow. No, I love the sun. We love the sun. It's the fact that it, like, it'll come out for 5 minutes, and then there'll be clouds, like, 5 minutes later.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Oh, it's insane. I don't remember this. What's this one?
Fuck, it's hot.
Oh, yeah, fuck, it's hot.
Yeah, it's a bit warm.
Crack
not
a beer.
Cold, is it?
Yeah, it's not cold.
Who put the fucking heater on? Bloody stinking hot, isn't it? Wow, I love heat. Woo. I'm feeling that.
Yeah.
Bet you can't get any hotter.
Bet you can't get any hotter. I love it. It's so great. Oh my gosh, you should come to Australia.
We would
welcome you with open arms.
People overhype the freaking animals and stuff.
Honestly, to be honest, I haven't seen a Huntsman in like 4 years. It's been a while.
It's been a minute, yeah.
Yeah. And there's not snakes everywhere. Like, obviously, if you're up in the bush, yeah. But, you know, if you're in town and stuff, there's not a random snake, like, slithering down the down the street or whatever.
Slithering down the snake.
Kangaroos, again, only in, like, paddocks and bushes and stuff. Mm. It is safe. It's safe. Aussie music. This is probably the most ochre you can get. And
it's like Aussie redneck, pretty much.
Yes, it's Aussie redneck. And you might not be able to understand all the words he says, so I'll only play a little bit. But this is like on the, redneck side of Australia. Play.
Punching cones in the dead of night. Packed a fucking fat one, now I'm fried. Fuck yeah, right.
Slim, crusty,
what
man.
What an excellent fucking cone and an even more splendid night. Fuck yeah, right.
Fuck yeah, right.
Yeah, right.
Let's get back and go to res. Racked a couple few, now I got the sweat. Fuck yeah, revs. I've only been there like a couple of times. Those couple of times are off their head. Fuck yeah, revs.
Yeah, definitely.
The tooth adds a bit of a, you know.
The tooth is great. Oh my gosh, it's great. But definitely, if you want to listen to any other songs that he's created, Slim.Crusty or Slim Crusty on TikTok. He's really funny. He's really talented too.
Yeah.
Oh my God, so good. And last but not least, what would the Aussie vernacular be without the word cunt?
No, no.
I don't know what it is about throat tattoos, but it's like once you get it, people just look at you very differently. I kind of liked it because I was like, oh yeah, I feel kind of like, oh, you know.
Yeah.
Different from everyone, but
I imagine it has the same effect as, like, I get my hair colored, obviously, and I've had it pink for quite a while. People look at you like you're a delinquent.
Like it's a delinquent?
And it's like, bitch, I'll stab you if I have to. But like, you don't have to assume that I'm going to do that. I'm from Western Sydney.
Yeah, so am I. I've never
kind of ghetto. Jesus.
You took it to the next level, my friend.
And I'll do it again, cunt.
There's going to be American people watching this. They're not going to be used to it being said like that. I don't know what it is about the American accent, but they give it so much more emphasis. And it sounds terrible.
They make it sound weird.
They go, cunt.
Yeah.
It's like, ooh. And when we say it, it's like, oh, what's up, cunt?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah,
anyways,
exactly.
Love to the Americans. We love you.
That's Melrose.
I don't know what it is about.
Melrose Avenue?
I think so.
Yeah. That's the lead singer of Melrose Avenue.
Mm.
Love them. Love them to death. They're highly recommend listening to their music. They're so good. So good. Now just chatting. Anything else you want to add before we end, Bree?
Oh my gosh.
I know, right? We've been through it.
I love the cats.
I know, they look like Monty and Haku, don't they?
Yeah.
So cute.
You're so cute.
Little babies.
Oh, it looks so grumpy.
Yeah, Monty's a grumpy ass.
He's a grumpy old boy.
He's a little grumpy boy. You have a festival friend from Australia and they say the same. Yeah, 100%. It's more so like, they're more so like wood spiders, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like we get the same kind of just little black house spiders that America gets.
Yeah. Little money spiders.
Yeah, and the Google house spider.
House spider. Okay, I'm gonna Google house spider.
We get a lot of those in our house.
Spider. We get a lot of, like, white tails, but, I mean, if you leave them alone, they'll leave you alone. Oh, yeah.
House spider, we get those sometimes.
And daddy long legs, but they're fine.
Yeah.
They can stay up in the corner and eat the flies and stuff.
We leave them alone.
They'll be all right.
Yeah. Yeah. Ooh, I'm getting heebie-jeebies looking at those spiders. I'm turning tight. I had to shut that real quick.
Oh my god.
I get the heebie-jeebies.
I don't mind spiders. I want a pet spider. I reckon that'd
be
nice.
I want you to leave.
I'm just gonna exit right now. Like, I'm not gonna leave.
Leave.
I love spiders. I think they're great. I never kill them. I always grab a piece of paper and like a cup and take them outside.
Well, that's where you and I differ.
I don't know. Yeah. But coming up, I think, wait, hold on. A week and a half? I'm going in for my hysterectomy, dude.
Oh, yeah.
That's coming up so soon. Did I tell you that the hospital called me and asked me if I wanted to be part of a study for endometriosis? Yeah. So basically they asked if I wanted to be part of two studies where while they're in there, they're going to take like, obviously they're going to take the endo out and also my uterus, but they're going to be able to, I gave them permission to test the tissue and stuff like that and use it for research. So hopefully, I don't know, hopefully that'll go towards finding a cure or a cause or something.
That would be cool.
Yeah.
You can help so many people.
Exactly. And I mean, I don't know why you wouldn't say no. It's like, I mean, you took my uterus. I'm not going to put it in a jar on a friggin' on a bookshelf somewhere. I don't need it. You can have it.
Just take it. I'm taking it home with me.
Yuck. Imagine.
Put it in a takeaway bag. Go.
I'll have a takeaway, thanks.
I wonder if people... Are you allowed to take it home?
I don't think so because it's biohazardous.
Right. Because I know that there's some things that you can take in a jar, but there's some things that you can't.
Interesting.
Don't ask me what it is. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm going to go through a massive rabbit hole just researching what body parts of mine can I take home after surgery. Oh, shit. Sell them on the black market. Well, technically, I'm not allowed to be an organ donor or a blood donor because I've had blood cancer in the past. Yep.
That sucks.
I'm contaminated. No. My shit's not good enough for anybody.
I'm a blood donor.
Very good. Well, you can save someone's life like mine. Oh, shit.
Oh, man.
That's great.
That's funny. That's funny.
Man. Well, we spoke about so much today. Holy crap.
It's been 2 hours.
2 hours, yeah.
Just talking.
Just shooting the shit.
It was fun.
It was fun. I'm excited to share more of my books with you guys. If you missed out, I'm going to upload this on YouTube. So if you're listening on YouTube, hey! And if you're listening on Spotify, hey! you can find the video on YouTube. But yeah, I'm excited to share my other reads with you. Oh shit, sorry, my bad.
She knocked over 10,000
cans. Oh my god. I actually have not drank Monster in quite a while. I'm proud of myself.
Is it V then?
Hey.
V?
No, I haven't drank any energy drinks. Thank you very much. I'm drinking Pepsi Max. So much more healthier.
You're like, don't shame me.
Oh, shit. But yeah, in my downtime, I'm going to have some time to catch up on reading, possibly writing. Yes. I would like to continue writing Dusk and Dawn 2. I've written a book, Don't Judge. I put it on Wattpad because this was years ago, okay? I didn't know you could self-publish. I'm going to self-publish through Amazon. And pop it on Kindle, but I gotta format the whole book first, and it's a big jump.
Oh,
so
no.
Maybe I can do that while I'm healing. I don't know. I might do that. But yes, there's things that I want to do on my downtime since I'm not going to be working for maybe like, I don't know, half a week. A week. We'll see.
Half a week. Wow.
Dude, I struggle taking time off work. It's hard. Because it's like, it's not I feel like I can't fully relax because I'm thinking about, well, when I get back to work, What am I going to have to come back to, sort of thing.
Yeah, yeah.
But we will see. I'm going to try and relax and create and just have fun while I'm dying inside. While my internal stitches are healing. While my intestines rearrange themselves.
Half my insides are gone.
Yeah, dude, apparently that's a thing. Like, when you get your uterus really? Taken out, your intestines...
Move?
Move. Yeah. Yeah.
They are move.
They are move. Yep. Yep.
They're on the move.
Gotta run, gotta oh, run, wow. gotta run!
Yeah.
It's better run. Oh, I'm an plankton. Idiot. I love plankton. It's great. Well, we've got some good music and shows and stuff to catch up on now. So
there,
I don't know whether...
Was, yes.
Oh, so good. I'm not sure whether we'll do this weekly. Maybe bi-weekly. I'm not sure.
Oh,
but,
yeah.
But yes, will be fun. I love being able to share my TikToks and reads and stuff with people who appreciate it. So thank you for listening.
Yes.
Yes. And we will see you in the next podcast, I suppose. If you like gaming stuff, we also game on Twitch. Yeah, I'll try and leave all the links down below, but I hope you enjoyed it. And I hope it opened your world to new series and movies and songs and books and Aussie stuff.
And stuff.
Stuff and things. Until next time, see you in the next one. Ta-ha.
Ta-ha.